And in fact, I found out that Islam, in the 7th century, already spoke about natural selection. In Arabic, the name of Muhammad, Muhammad's got many names, but one of the most important names is Mustafa. Mustafa in Arabic means he who was selected. And the idea is that since the time of Adam, the first human being, God selected from every generation the best of all the descendants of Adam. So there was some kind of natural selection, one generation after the other. Until at the end, he selected the best of the best of the best of the best. And this is the Prophet Muhammad. And he chose him to give him his word, the exact word of God, and of course selected him to be the prophet that will bring to humanity the finest of all revelations. This is Islam. Now, Islam is not a religion in the ordinary, simple way of thinking. Islam is a culture which comprises everything. And most of all, it is a culture based on revelation, and it is a culture which is based on a legal system. It is basically a legal system. It is a legal system which comprises everything. It comprises the life of the individual, it comprises the life of the society, it comprises the state. That's one thing. Secondly, it is a world religion. It's not like Judaism, which is not a world religion. It is connected with the chosen people, and it's only for them. And it's not connected with the territory of the world, it's connected with one small country. Islam is a world religion connected with the world, and it is one. It wants to establish world order. For Islam, the whole world is one state. In Surah 61, verses 11-13, we hear that God sent Muhammad with the true religion, with the right message, with the right path, which means that there is only one truth.
هو الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره المشركون.
Jews and Christians, which are called the people of the book, and they falsified their books. That's why Allah had to send another prophet, a modern prophet, that should bring the last word of God and the only word of God to humanity. This is the Quran. Nothing can be superior to it. And because of that, this religion is regarded to be one that stands on top of everything else. In Arabic, they say, Al-Islam ya'lu wa la yu'la alayhi. Islam is superior, nothing can be superior to it. Which means we are talking about not only the final word of God, not only about the finest word of God, but the truest of all revelations. What does the community have to do? The community of the believers. Those people that were lucky enough to have their hearts open and to have accepted the call of the Prophet Muhammad. What do they have to do? They have a mission in this world. To bring the word of God.
On revient toujours à cette fameuse affaire de la religion des origines. Adam était un musulman. Abraham, j'allais dire encore plus, était un musulman. Moïse était un musulman. Jésus était un musulman. Tous ceux qui n'ont pas abandonné la religion initiale étaient des musulmans. Mais une grande partie des juifs et des chrétiens ont erré. Ils ont falsifié leurs écritures. C'est déjà dans le Coran et encore plus dans la tradition interprétante. Oui. Par conséquent, ils ont quitté la vraie religion originelle, qui était la religion d'El Fitra, de la nature conforme à ce que Dieu voulait. El Fitra, Fatara, ça veut dire créer, la nature créée par Dieu. Donc, en fait, il n'y a qu'une seule religion, c'est l'islam. Qui existait déjà avant Mahomet.
Au moment où est écrit le Coran, on n'a pas encore cette idée qu'en fin de compte, il y aurait plusieurs histoires de Dieu avec l'homme. Donc il n'y a pas trois religions. Donc évidemment, aujourd'hui, les musulmans considèrent que Jésus est musulman. Mais Moïse aussi. Et Abraham est même le premier musulman. Donc, et c'est pour ça aussi d'ailleurs que on nomme les chrétiens comme mushrikin, parce que c'est péjoratif, et les juifs comme kuffar, parce que c'est péjoratif.
De la même façon que les premiers chrétiens avaient transformé le judaïsme en hérésie chrétienne, le Coran transforme le judaïsme et le christianisme en hérésie de l'islam. L'islam n'est pas la religion de Mahomet. L'islam est la religion d'Abraham. L'islam est la véritable religion, a été révélée par Dieu à Abraham. Les juifs l'ont perverti, puis les chrétiens l'ont perverti, et Mohammed retourne à la véritable tradition de la révélation divine à Abraham, qui est la seule religion vraie, toutes les autres religions monothéistes étant des perversions de ce seul et unique véritable message de Dieu à l'humanité.